out of sight. And when she said that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave her a kind of inspiration and talked to her through Jibreel, until Jibreel. And until Jibreel cried to her from the underneath and said to her, and he said to her, and do not be grieved, do not grieve, grieve not. Your Lord has provided a water stream under you. Right under you, you can see water stream. And then what you do, shake the trunk of the palm tree and towards you, and when you shake it towards you, you will find that a fresh ripe crops will fall to you, which are dates. And when they fall upon you, then you see it, so eat and drink, eat from that fruits and drink the water under you and enjoy by looking at your baby and have comfort. So enjoy that. Allah is talking to her like that. So what can you learn from there? First of all, it was a summer time. Because of that, she was alone outside. And again, when she was outside like that, then she was rushing to go to the tree to look for a shade. So she was going under the tree, at least to get a shade there. So the shadow of the tree, she went to that place, and then when she went there, there's no shadow when it is a winter. And trees are also, they cannot produce fruits. So fruits came, and then water came, so then she was thirsty. She was hungry and thirsty. And at the same time, she needed the shadow. All those phenomena come in the summer time, not in the winter time. So what you see there is that it's very clear, this verse confirms what is written in all the four Gospels that shows the date when Jesus was born. Then go back to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He himself didn't know when he was born. And again, use a logic. Before we go to the Quran or Hadiths, think in a logic way. The date we have with our calendar today, that is an Islamic calendar, the Hijri, did not exist at that time when Jesus, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. So the calendar was started, the calendar was based on the immigration of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Mecca to Medina. And that time, he was close to 50 years old. He was almost 50 years old. So you cannot count back to another date, which is obscure. Nobody knows. And again, even this calendar was not applied right away after the immigration of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It was applied after his death. So then, how can you base something which is innovative after, you can take it back to another calculation or another date? It's illogical. So very simple, we can see that when we use our logic, our history, just the history and the logic and the academic way and the religious points of view, both from the Bible and the Quran, you can very clearly see that these dates are made up by men. They are all fabricated by human beings. And how they fabricated is a big story, but hopefully we don't have time for it. Inshallah, I will try to mention just at least an abstract of it. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, first of all, my point is not to criticize any culture or to condemn anyone or any community, but it is that we should know what we are doing, and we should not leave the Islamic culture for something which has no base at all. It's very simple. So then, and in advance, I want to mention that in case it comes to you that you have friends who have that celebration for celebrate on 25th December, and they may request you to accompany them to that place, and you have respect for them, what you should do? While you know it is something which is fabricated by human being, then it's very simple. What to do is what Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did when they asked him to go with them for the celebration of their idols. What he said was that فَنَذَرَ نَذْرَةً فِي الْمُجُودِ فَقَالَ إِنِّي سَقِيمٌ. He looked at the sky, made himself something like kind of thinking, and then he said to them, إِنِّي سَقِيمٌ, I'm not feeling well today. So he made an excuse. So he excused himself from going with them to that celebration. Simply, that's what you can do. Just make an excuse. Maybe you don't want to lose your friends, and you don't want to go there, make an excuse. It's very easy. And then, protect your children. Because what happens in those days, these days of the celebrations are the days when most of the teenagers go astray to the wrong way. Because it is the days when that celebration is based on wildness. It is based on committing crimes, falling into sins, killing, drinking, and taking drugs, all that. That the celebration itself was meant for that reason. And that, because we don't have time, just to summarize, previously the Romans, and that's before Christianity and before Islam, those Romans, their worshipping was, they had several ways of worshipping, but all of them were based on the nature, or they were looking at the sky and something like that. And what happened to them? They were divided into groups. A group of them were worshipping the sun. Another group were worshipping the moon. Another group were worshipping the fire. Another group were worshipping the vegetation, the trees. But then what happened, just to go to the point, is that when Christianity was spreading throughout those countries, within the pagans of the Romans, and many people converted to Christianity, and there were conflicts between the pagans and the Christians. And finally, they came to negotiation. And that negotiation was concluded to say that, okay, let us say this, let's take some parts of yours and some parts of ours, bring them together, and we modify them. And the agreement became, they said, we cannot stop celebrating for the 25th December. So they said, the Christians accepted us that to be that day to be an official day of holidays. But that holiday, they said, we will say it is when Jesus was born. And then pagans accepted. And they have taken also their months, January, December, all of them, which are just, you see, like December is the 12th, the Roman language, and November 11th, October 10th, it's just the numbers, and some of them are named after somebody. And how it came was that when those, the two groups, or two faiths, had a conflict, there were a war between two. That war was between the worshippers of the sun and the worshippers of the moon. What happened was the worshippers of the moon defeated the worshippers of the sun for a period of time. And that time came to the time that we are in now. It was a winter time. And that winter time, the days shrinks slowly, slowly from corners, from front and back. You see, the hours of the day are getting smaller and smaller in the winter time. So then, and the days becomes less, and the hot goes out, the cold becomes increasing. And what they said the God of the sun was defeated. Now, he has gone his history, because he is not working anymore. He has only a few hours left for him. And again, they captured also some cities from the worshippers of the sun. After that, what happened was they realized the worshippers of the sun waged a war against the worshippers of the moon, and they captured some of their towns back in these days of December, December 1st up until December 25th. Actually, December 17th up to December 25th. That week, they captured some cities. And after they captured, they have seen, after December 25th, you can realize now. The day comes back, the day comes back slowly, slowly, minute by minute. So if you reach at December 25, you can find December 27, 28, the day gets back 1 minute, 2 minutes, like that. So the day is covering, it's recovering. Then they said, this is very clear that our God of the sun has won now. Then that's how they made the celebration. And the celebration was, they said, okay, how to celebrate this Easter week? We celebrate every year from December 17th up until December 25th. That week, anyone is free to kill anyone he wants, to rob, to rape, to destroy. You are free that day. No crime is counted. It's called lawless week. There's no law working. And but then at the end, when it is December 25th, they said we have to give gifts to each other, or gifts to the God of the sun. That God of the sun, they were preparing gifts for him, and that gift is the gift which we see today. And then they said, okay, how to do that also? In order to make sure that 25th is the day when the son of the God, the God of the sun won, you have to make a very clear celebration, which is sacrificial. What to sacrifice is to catch the strongest man of that community, to catch him and put him in, handcuff him and hang him up to kill him, to kill that person. And that is, he said, they come even voluntarily. So it is to sacrifice for that God, that this day we give you our strongest man, and our sins then we are forgiven. So the sins and crimes committed throughout the week are forgiven because of that man. That is how, it's a very long story. You can read many books that I already has mentioned. But I think my point is that there's no point in religion. When you are a religious person, you don't need to celebrate for any birthday at all. Even yours, even the one of your children. If somebody didn't progress for a period of time, when that progress is accomplished, then you can make a kind of a celebration for that person and for the accomplishment of their work, but you cannot make it regular celebration every year. It is very clear that then the what we see, the practicality today shows us what this celebration is and what brought it and why it came to exist and all that. And it's written in many books. It's not something that I'm making up. وأذكركم بأمر بدأ الله بنفسه ثم أمر بالملائكة ثم أمرنا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.